Hey everyone, in today's class we are going to see demonstration of experiments using virtual labs. Okay, so you just open your browser and type vlab.co.in. okay, then it will take us to a new page which looks like this. So this virtual labs is being developed by the Ministry of Human Resource Development, and with the help of these virtual labs, anyone can access this virtual labs from anywhere. And the areas in which these virtual labs are being provided include your electronics and communication engineering also. So as we belong to the electronics and communication, click electronics and communication. Then under the domain electronics and communication, there are some laboratories which are already developed, and we will be looking at one of the laboratory by name Basic Electronics Lab, developed by IIT Kharagpur, looking at the syllabus which will be more or less coincident with the syllabus of our Electronic Circuits and Analysis Lab, what we are having in this semester. Okay, so for that reason, at least for the first half cycle, we will be making use of this particular Basic Electronics Lab developed by IIT Kharagpur for carrying out our experiments in the first cycle of this particular lab, Electronic Circuits and Analysis 1 lab. Okay, right. So when we move on to this Basic Electronics Laboratory, right, so this is a virtual laboratory which one can access remotely from anywhere, right. So here you could see contents like introduction. Okay, so what is meant by this virtual laboratory, how it is being helpful to the teachers, how it is being helpful to the students, and so on and so forth. And you could see the list of experiments so that you can have an idea the coincidence of the list of experiments, what do we have in our syllabus, and what are the available list of experiments under this Basic Electronics virtual laboratory. And when we click this list of experiments, you could see the characteristics of a diode: half wave rectification, full wave rectification, capacitive rectification, that is rectifiers using filters, and Jena diode voltage regulator, common base characteristics, common emitter characteristics, and CE amplifier frequency response characteristics. Okay, then you can look at your RC differentiator and integrator, what we looked at in our unit 1, right. So whatever the possible experiments that we could see in this particular laboratory, Basic Electronics virtual laboratory, we will be using those experiments from this laboratory. And the rest of the other experiments which are present in our syllabus, that we will look for some other laboratory developed by some other IIT. Okay, but for the time being, at least for the first half cycle, we could follow this particular Basic Electronics virtual laboratory for carrying out our experiments. Okay, so I'll show you how to use our experiments on a weekly basis. So that means we will be following something like this. On the day of laboratory, I'll be explaining you the experiment that you are supposed to do, and I'll let you know how to proceed with the experiments, listing out what are the components required, what is the aim of that experiment, and so on and so forth. And once it is being demonstrated through this virtual laboratory, then you will be doing yourself with different type of diodes that are available in the same virtual lab. Then you will be making a note of all your observations, and you will be plotting the graph by yourself on your paper. Then you will be taking the snapshot and submitting as the record at the end of the experiment. Okay, so the one particular experiment will be winded up only upon completion of attempting the quiz based on that experiment. Okay, so as our first experiment is finding the VI characteristics of a diode, I am clicking this VI characteristics of a diode. Okay, so when I click VI characteristics of a diode, you could see again some theory related to this experiment and the procedure, how you need to proceed in carrying out this particular experiment, and the simulation. Okay, how we'll proceed for executing our experiment, that we'll see in this simulation. And there is some quiz also to test ourselves that to what extent we have understood regarding this PN junction diode and so on. Okay, so directly I'll be moving on to this simulation part, right? So in the simulation part, so we were aimed at finding out the VI characteristics of the diode, in particular forward biased characteristics of the silicon diode and reverse biased characteristics of the silicon diode. Those germanium diode and forward bias characteristics of germanium diode and reverse bias characteristics of germanium diode are given. So it is left to you for self study regarding this germanium diode. But nevertheless, what is to be recorded after completion of this experiment is forward biased silicon diode and reverse biased silicon diode. Okay. So let me click this forward biased silicon diode. So this is what is the setup that will be shown in carrying out your forward biased silicon diode. Okay. So here you could see the instruction, that is what you need to follow in carrying out this particular experiment. And here is the experimental table. Okay, that is what you need to take the observations. Okay, so the experimental table includes the forward voltage across the diode and the forward current flowing through the diode. Okay, and here is the experimental setup. What are the components that we are using in carrying out this VI characteristics of the PN junction diode? Is one is a PN junction diode, okay, and one resistor to limit the maximum current not to flow through the diode. That means diode can withstand up to a maximum current listed in its data sheet. So I have to make sure that the current flowing through the diode should not exceed that maximum rated current, otherwise diode is going to get damaged. So in order to limit the current to the not to be beyond this maximum value, rated maximum value, I have to use one resistor here. Okay, and in order to observe the current flowing through the diode, I have kept here an ammeter. And to observe the voltage across the diode, I have kept a voltmeter across the diode. Okay, and because I am interested in forward biasing the diode, I have make sure that because I am interested in forward biasing my diode, okay, so I made my P side of my diode more in potential than the N side of my diode by connecting my P side of the diode to the positive terminal of the battery and N side of the diode to the negative terminal of the battery. Okay, so is this setup is okay? This setup is meant for operating your device in the forward bias region by ensuring that your P side is more in potential than the N side, right? So that means we are interested in obtaining the VI characteristics of the diode when it is being operated in the forward bias region. Okay, and now let us look at the instruction what we need to follow in order to carry out this experiment. Set DC voltage to 0.2 volts. So this is what is the DC voltage. Okay, so you set that to 0.2 volts. Okay, so I am setting my DC voltage to 0.2 volts initially. Then you select the diode. So here there is a possibility that I need to choose my diode. So I'll click here. There are some various types of diodes that are available. Okay, so I'll be choosing one of the diode which is most frequently used in laboratory experiments, that is 1N4007. Okay, so when I click this, immediately you could see the forward biased voltage across the diode is found to be 0.6 volts. Okay, 0.6 volts, right? So that happens immediately the moment you select the diode. For example, if I had selected this particular diode, then my forward biased voltage is 0.5 instead of 0.6. So each diode is having their predetermined forward biased voltage. So when I select this particular diode, its forward bias voltage is 0.6 volts. Okay, right. So let us see what is the next instruction. Set the resistor. Okay, so I am selecting my resistor. Okay, so to a maximum of 100 ohms. Okay, I have set to some value, let it be some 100 ohms. Okay, now voltmeter is placed parallel to the silicon diode. Yes, it is already placed. And ammeter series with the resistor, it is already placed. The positive side of the battery to the P side, that is anode, and the negative of the battery to the N side, that is cathode of the diode, is what is being connected in order to make your diode forward biased. Now vary the voltage up to 5 volts, okay, and note the voltmeter and ammeter reading for a particular DC voltage. So that means what? You need to vary this particular DC voltage from 0.22 up to 5 volts, and you need to note down the corresponding diode voltage and the diode current. Okay, right. So while noting down the readings in your notebook, not only follow these two particular columns, but also you include another column for VDC. okay, as you will be varying your VDC from 0.2 to 5 volts and you will be noting down your forward voltage across the diode and forward current through the diode, you need to draw in your notebook three columns, one for VDC, another for voltage across the diode, another for current through the diode. Okay, right. So now let us start doing our experiment. Okay, so what is that we need to do? We need to vary our DC voltage right from 0.2 to 5 volts, and then we need to note down the corresponding voltages and the currents through the diodes. Okay, so let me add table here. Let me click add to table here. So what are the values that I have chosen? Initially my VDC is 0.2, and now I want to look at what is my voltage across the diode and current through the diode. Okay, so when once I click add to the table, with this applied DC voltage that is 0.2, my voltage across the diode is 0 and my current through the diode is 0. Okay, so why? Because more than 0.6 volts is supposed to be applied across the diode in order some current to flow through the diode. Okay, but as this voltage, DC voltage itself is 0.2 volts. Okay, so you could see that there is no voltage applied across your diode which is no more than 0.6 volts. So that is why no current results through the diode. Okay, so let me keep on increasing this DC voltage and let us try to understand how does the voltage across the diode and current through the diode are going to vary. Okay, so I am changing this DC voltage to 0.5 and I am tabulating. Okay, so when I applied some 0.8 volts as my DC voltage, the voltage across the diode that you could observe is 0.593. because of some drop across this 100 ohms resistor, the voltage that is appearing across the diode is only 0.593. and because of that applied voltage across the diode, some current that is flowing, that is being given as 1.99 milliamperes. Whatever the current that is flowing through your diode is milliamperes. Okay, so I'll be keep on varying this DC voltage right from 0.22 up to 5 volts, and I'll be keep on observing my forward voltage across the diode and current through the diode. Okay, so this time let me make it as 1.1 volts and add to table. Okay, you have to add one more column here for VDC, and each time the value that you have set here for VDC while adding table, you have to include these two values in addition to this VDC is equal to 1.1 volts. Okay, right. So I'll be varying my voltage to 1.4, so that my voltage across the diode and current through the diode are going to vary. And let me vary my DC voltage to further. Let me vary my DC voltage to further. So you need to note down all these values of your VDC also. Don't forget to add one more column for this VDC. Okay, though it is not given in the experimental table in the virtual laboratory, you add this VDC in the your table also. So that for each DC voltage, you note down the corresponding forward bias voltage and the forward current through the diode. Okay. So I have taken here 2.3, and let me note down for the corresponding to 2.3, what is the voltage and the current through the diode? 2.7. Okay. And 3 volts. And let it be 3.4 volts. Okay. For each value of my VDC, I am finding out what is my voltage across the diode and current through the diode. Okay, and how long I need to vary this VDC? Up to 5 volts. Okay, so until my VDC is equal to 5 volts, you keep on varying your VDC and you note down the corresponding voltage across the diode and the current through the diode. Okay, so lastly, I'll be winding up varying my VDC by 5. Okay, so you can have an observation. Okay, you can have an observation that your voltage across the diode and current through the diode, upon increasing your VDC right from 0.2 volts to up to 5 volts. Okay, you could see that this is the voltage across your diode and this is the current through your diode. Okay, so you can see that how does the current is being varying with respect to the varying in the voltage. Okay, so when I click plot here, okay, so what is all that you have to do? In addition to these two columns for your forward voltage and the forward current, you should not forget to add one more column, that is for VDC. And as you are varying your VDC right from 0.2 to 5, you need to note down the corresponding values of your forward voltage and the current through the diodes. Okay, then when you click your plot here, automatically it gives you some plot which is similar to your VI characteristics of your diode. Okay, so here you could see that some cut-in voltage likely to be some 0.6. Okay, exactly it is 0.593 is your cut-in voltage where your current starts to increase exponentially. Okay, so when once you have got this particular VI characteristics of your silicon diode when operated in the forward bias region, then you are asked to find out what is the static resistance and the dynamic resistance. For finding the static resistance, you have to locate an operating point somewhere here roughly. So at this particular point, for example, my voltage is found to be 0.627 volts and my current is found to be 23.9 milliamperes. So my static resistance is given by voltage by current. Okay, so which will be normally in terms of ohms that you will be getting, some hundreds of ohms that you will be getting as your static resistance. And similarly, you can find your dynamic resistance. Dynamic resistance can be found with a formula like as I explained in the classroom, that dynamic resistance is always been given by Vt by Id. At the same operating point, whatever you have chosen in determining the static resistance, the same operating point you take for taking down your current, that is DC current. In this case, it is 23.9 milliamperes. So R is being given by Vt by Id, where Id is 23.9 milliamperes and R is being given and Vt is being given by 26 millivolts. Okay, so 26 millivolts by 23.9 milliamperes is what is being giving your dynamic resistance. In general, dynamic resistance will be smaller in magnitude compared to the static resistance. Okay, right. So this is what you are expected from this forward bias characteristics of your silicon diode. Okay, so what you have to do as a part of doing the experiment is you need to vary your DC voltage right from 0.2 volts to 5, and you need to note down the corresponding voltage across the diode and current through the diode. And from the readings, when you plot your readings, you can have a graph that is how it is going to look exactly like this. Okay, and from this graph you need to obtain what is your static resistance and the dynamic resistance. Okay, all right. Okay, now let us see the reverse bias characteristics of the silicon diode. Okay, this is the reverse biased silicon diode. So this is what is the setup that you could see, the same setup except that diode has been reversed in its position. Okay, so this time my N side is being made more in potential by connecting through the positive of the battery than the P side, because P side is connected to the negative of the battery. Okay, that means you are operating your diode in the reverse bias region now. Okay, so again as usual, okay, so what is that I have to do is I have to select my diode. In this case, let us choose the diode what you have chosen while carrying out your forward bias characteristics. Otherwise, doing one diode in the forward bias characteristics and using another diode in reverse bias characteristics, it makes no sense. Okay, so please do, you take only one particular diode when operating in both the forward bias and the reverse bias, so that you can understand about one particular diode completely, its reverse bias and forward bias characteristics. Okay, so when once I choose here, okay, because this is already been made as setup for the reverse bias characteristics, its VR is being shown here as 30. VR means what is the maximum voltage that your diode can withstand when it is being operated in the reverse bias. Okay, that is what is this VR is. Normally it is called as breakdown voltage. Okay, so when my voltage when it is being operated in the reverse bias across the diode is more than this 30 volts, 100% it is going to get damaged. Okay, so what is all that I have to do is, as usual, I have to vary my DC voltage, making your resistance as some value. Okay, here also I have kept my resistance to be some 100, then my DC voltage is kept to be 0.2 volts, and just like the earlier case, I'll be keep on varying my DC voltage and I'll be trying to observe what is my voltage across the diode and current through the diode. Okay, so I'll be adding to table so that initially my voltage across the diode is going to be this much and my current through the diode is this much, that is almost zero. Okay, so I'll keep on vary this DC voltage. Okay, right from 0.2 to 1.85. So again, as usual, just like how you proceeded for your forward bias characteristics, add one more column for your VDC, and for each value of your VDC, note down the corresponding value of reverse voltage and the reverse current. Okay, right. So for the corresponding 1.85 volts DC, okay, so my reverse voltage across the diode is 1.14 volts and the reverse current is almost zero. Okay, so I will keep on varying this voltage and I am making the observations. I am varying the voltage and I am making the observations. Okay, so vary DC voltage and for that particular value, tabulate the values of your voltage across the diode and current through the diode. Okay, you just make a note of what is the VDC value that you are choosing. And note down the corresponding values of your voltage across the diode and the current through the diode. Okay, then your values are being tabulated and you can have an observation at that and you can understand how does your characteristics of the diode are going to be varying when it is being operated in the reverse bias. Okay, so I'll be varying up to more or less 30. Okay, so now you can see that how does your readings are being varying. Okay, so my reverse voltage is keep on getting increased and my current is also keep on getting increased. Okay, you could see that with increase in your reverse voltage, my current is also increasing. So when I click plot here, okay, so you could have an observation of how does your current is getting varied with respect to your voltage when your diode is being operated in the reverse bias. That is why it is shown that negative voltage, because in the reverse bias means you are applying your voltage to be negative, and the current that is flowing in the through the N side to the P side, it is shown as a negative current. So this is how it is being varying with increase in your reverse voltage. Okay, right. So this is what is your reverse bias characteristics, and earlier we have seen the forward bias characteristics. Okay, so both the regions you need to perform considering your silicon diode. Okay, so this is what is our first experiment is, right. So nevertheless, in both the experiments, in both the cases of forward bias and the reverse bias, ensure that one more column is getting added here for the purpose of VDC, and for each value of your VDC which you are varying, right, from 0.2 to 30 volts in this case and 0.2 to 5 volts in the forward bias case, while noting down the corresponding voltage across the diode and current through the diodes. Okay, and then you make a plot, not taking the snapshot of this particular thing. You just plot it yourself by using this particular tabulated values. Okay, that is voltage across the diode and current through the diode. You use them for plotting so that you will be getting exactly like what is being shown here. Okay, you need not take this screenshot. Instead, you can draw it yourself so that you can have a better understanding, and then you can take the snapshot of that, and then you can submit it as a record of your first experiment. Okay, right. So I hope you have understood how to carry out how to do the first experiment, that is VI characteristics of silicon diode in both the forward bias and reverse bias characteristics. Okay, so I will be giving you the type of diodes that the corresponding batch need to use. I list out that which batch has to take which particular diode based on the availability of diodes in this particular virtual lab. Accordingly, you choose the appropriate diode and then you carry on this particular procedure. Then tabulate the values, then plot the graph, and then you find out your static resistance and dynamic resistance in the case of your forward bias characteristics. And reverse bias, you just have an observation that how does your current through the diode is going to be varying. Though ideally it is thought to be that it is almost zero, but in practice there is a small amount of current that is flowing, at least in terms of microamperes. Okay, so this is regarding your first experiment, that is what you need to carry out using these virtual labs, that is our VI characteristics of silicon diode. Okay, so I hope you have understood this. Okay, thank you very much. See you next time.